హాయ్ హలో వెల్కమ్ టు టీఎఫ్పీసీ దిస్ ఇస్ కావ్య సో రాజీవ్ పిల్లై నాతో పాటు ఉన్నారు సో ఇంకేం మాత్రం ఆలస్యం చేయకుండా చాలా చాలా ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ క్వశ్చన్స్ తో ఆయనని టార్చర్ చేద్దాం యా హాయ్
హాయ్ అందరికీ నమస్కారం
ఇది చీటింగ్ నేను చెప్పుతా అనుకున్నాను అందరూ బాగున్నారా
బాగున్నారా యా యా ఐ యామ్ గుడ్
మీన్స్ హౌ ఆర్ యు
ఐ యామ్ గుడ్ ఐ యామ్ గుడ్
ఓకే సో రాజీవ్ హౌ డిడ్ షకీలా మూవీ హ్యాపెన్ వెన్ ఇట్
The Shakila movie, in fact, I knew the director. Okay, so you must have seen the movies which I have done. So he called me. I knew Indrajit Langesh sir. Because of him, I am a part of this movie. Yeah,
okay.
That's as simple as that.
Okay. Do you know before like Shakila's bio, like her history or
yeah,
story?
Yeah, in fact, yeah. I am a Malayali, so Shakila became a star in Kerala first.
Mm-hmm.
So all the movies, all the super hit movies were made in Malayalam itself. That was a time when we were studying in schools and all. That is when she became a star. The stardom did last for, I guess, for almost 3 years it was there. And then it slowly faded. But then eventually in that span of 3 years, she had done, I don't know, maybe 60, 70 movies as heroine. Yeah, but it was there, it was big. So I could see, I mean, I wouldn't be lying. I also watched her movies, but then we all knew that whichever movie she is releasing, that's gonna be a hit. That was the kind of stardom she had.
Yeah. So one thing you learned from, like inspired from Shakila, what is that?
As honest as you can. I mean, I have met her. So we had. A press meet in Chennai as well and Bangalore also. That is when I actually met her. So what I have noticed in the way she was interacting with the press, she was very honest. She never wanted to hide anything. Eventually, as a matter of fact, at that age in 2000 and all, whatever she was showing on the screen was much less than a mainstream heroine is doing now. Okay. So, of course, the movies have evolved, but she was very, she was considered outspoken, but I don't think so. She is not outspoken. She is straight.
Okay.
Yeah.
Out of Shakila and Richa, who is your favorite?
No, I spent time with Richa. She was my co-star. I mean, I was Shakila's, I mean, Richa's boyfriend in the movie. So, we showed together, we spent time together, obviously. Richa being the kind of actor she is, she's a fantastic actor, and she is she never shows any tantrum or anything of that sort. So I don't know Shakila ma'am as such. I have met her for the press release. Of course, I have spent time with Richa, so the connection with Richa is more. Yes.
Yeah, during this pandemic situation, do you think Shakila movie can grab the audience to the theatres?
That's a very tricky question, in fact. I think it depends on the mindset of the people, right? In few states, people are coming to watch movies. In some of the states, people are still hesitant to get out of the house also. Mm-hmm. So it's a very tricky question and I can only hope that it will bring people to the theatres. Yeah, that is what we all pray for.
Yeah. So, you got inspired from Shakila that being honest is like a superb thing, right?
Yeah.
So
I just said I got inspired.
Yeah. So, I'm going to ask you a few questions. So, you have to answer it in a very honest way.
Okay.
Right? Yeah. My first question, your first kiss. did you expect this question?
No, I did not. I was when you were studying.
Okay.
Yeah, when I was in my college.
In your college?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Not in my school.
Oh. Okay. Your first crush?
My first crush was Shobhana, ma'am. Shobhana is an actress.
Wow.
Yeah, she was my first crush. Yeah.
Wow, yeah. You have good taste.
Thank you.
Okay, what is the one thing you admire most in Shobhana garu?
The elegance, probably, yeah. At that point of time also, I mean, she was much above her contemporaries at that point of time as well. And she was really good. Everything about her, not even, no, I cannot point out a single thing.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Your first college bunk or school bunk, something like?
I used to bunk schools to watch Sachin Tendulkar play. Yeah, that was when I was a child also. Mm-hmm. I used to go out saying that I have some stomach upset or headache or something of that sort. And I go and watch Sachin play. That was a very common thing at that point of time. Maybe that was a normal thing for children of my age at that point of time. Mm-hmm. We all grew up watching him play.
Okay. What's your height?
I'm 181, 6.
Okay. So my next question is like, did you slap anybody?
Yeah, I did.
At early stages, like first time?
Yeah, that when you're a teenager, you're not in control of your emotions. Yeah. I did get into a few fights at that point of time when you are really young. Yeah.
At your young age, you are like a hero thing or villain type of?
No, I was more like an introvert kind of guy, and I was opening up only to my friends. Mm-hmm. But then your friends get you into trouble, then you are also part of that. So eventually it was like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
You first time you caught lying?
I was with my mother. I used to do that all the time, every time.
What then, type of lies you used to
say? Yes, we are not... I'm from not only me, we were that point of time, the families used to be so conservative. They always wanted their children to study. So they never wanted them to go and play and become something of that. So that mindset was not there at all. So whenever you go for playing something and when you come back late, you will have to make up a lie, something of that sort, so that your mother will believe that this has happened. But the next day itself, I'll be caught. My mother, she was a school teacher, in fact. She's retired now. So eventually, it was very easy for her to find out that whether I'm lying or not. So it was like that. I used to lie to her. Even now also, sometimes I do lie to her. Not very serious lies, but they are.
Okay, Rajesh's mother, you have to watch this video. Yeah. So your first love.
That was when I was in 11th standard, I guess. It was one way. Plus one and plus two.
One way?
Yeah, yeah. Plus one and plus two passed. I hardly spoke to her 2-3 times. That's it.
You answer it as love?
Yeah, that was love for me at that time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is she your school, like college mate?
College mate. Yeah, she went after that. After
you never proposed her?
No.
Why so?
No,
you said you are an introvert?
Yeah, her talking to me itself was fine with me that time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your first heartbreak?
That's after I finished my course. When I was 22, 23, that time.
Okay.
That was the first.
First love.
Yeah, yeah, that was the first
no,
love.
No, I mean, you said it.
No, the first crush, which I call love, you said that cannot be called as love.
Okay. Yeah. Later, something was broken, right?
Yeah, that was
true love.
That was true way.
That was not true love.
That was true love only.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it happens with everyone. That's not a big deal nowadays.
So, how did you came out of that heartbreaking thing?
The first time it was difficult.
It's like, how many times did your heart break? Oh my god.
The first time it was difficult. But then I got used to it.
So can we know how many breakups did you face?
I cannot count it, but more than once, of course.
More than? This is crazy. I think 10?
No, not that much. Huh. Yeah, not 10.
Below 5 or 10? Below 10?
5, around 5.
I think 5 is a good figure, so that's why you are ending up with 5. Okay. Your first traffic challan?
After I bought my own car, I was caught many times. Yeah, the first, I mean, the usual things. Seat belt, everyone has to wear the seat belt, yeah. And then that was the time when I was caught first, I guess. Not then, sometimes speed limit. Of course, you have to go in the speed limit again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the usual things.
Okay. Did you watch any film alone? Solo movie experience?
I watch most of the movies alone. Most of 90% of the movies which I watch it alone. So I, that is the way I like it. Rather than watching, of course, if it's a cricket match or anything, that sort of, any sports game, sports or games, you tend to watch it with your friends, but the movies, I want to watch it alone.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That gives me, you know, more me time.
Mm. Do you have any male crush? I think that's not a wrong thing.
I don't have any male crush, but then I used to admire a lot of actors and models when I was growing up. So you wouldn't say that it's a crush, but it's like more like a respect. Or I used to idolize them when I was growing up. I wanted to be like them.
Okay.
It's not a crush.
Who is that person you admired most?
Of course, the first one was Sachin Tendulkar. Then Hrithik Roshan, John Abraham at that age when you're growing up, yeah.
Wow, superb. Your first audition?
My first audition was long back, almost 10 years back.
Mm.
I got my first movie on my 32nd audition.
You counted it?
Yeah. Every time I used to count it because after some time, after your 10th or 11th audition, after your 10th audition, you feel like, okay, go give audition. And if somebody calls you back, no, it must be a mistake, not me. Then you get used to it. But it was my 32nd, I got my first movie.
Okay. Your first paycheck in industry?
Does modeling count on that? No.
Okay, anything,
I used to be a model before. So, yeah, that was the first paycheck.
How much can we know?
That was very small.
You sound interesting. Okay. You don't want to reveal? You said, I'll answer honestly.
I got some 2,000 rupees or 2,500 for that. That's it.
That's good.
Yeah.
Not bad. Your first date? You don't call it love, you don't call it anything. But everything happens, huh?
Yeah, the first date when I was studying with a friend of mine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You didn't call it the date as such because she was a friend of mine.
Oh.
So we used to go out and then we used to go out in
you
a group.
You can plan a date with your friend?
Yeah, you can if you want.
You are changing all the meanings in the dictionary, I think.
It all depends on your mindset, the mentality which you are in. Mm. You want to make it a date, you can.
Oh, super. Okay, where did you go?
There was a small an ice cream parlor next to the college where I was studying. So, mm-hmm. We went over there.
Okay. Your first flight experience?
It was to when I went for my higher studies. That was the first time I actually got into a flight. To London. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Your first trip. Something you went a long, long trip like that.
Is it like me alone or as a group?
Whatever. First trip.
First trip was in my school. Mm. My school trip.
School trip.
Yeah, school trip. Yeah.
I love this answer.
Yeah.
Where did you went?
It was always Kanyakumari for us.
Wow.
It was very close to us.
Yeah.
But every year from our school, they will take us only to Kanyakumari.
Mm.
On the way, they will drop us in Trivandrum, okay, which is like the state capital.
Mm.
So after the first year, we knew where exactly are they going to stop, what time is the stop, where will we get the food, and then what time we'll reach Kanyakumari, and what is our headmaster going to say or the principal going to say. Everything we knew. For almost 5 years, we went to the same spot. And I was
because it is like nearby.
Yeah, it is nearby in the sense it's pretty far from our village, where our school was. But then it's close to Kerala. Kanyakumari is Kerala itself, hardly 1 hour from Trivandrum. That's it.
Mm. Okay. Do you have any pets?
Yeah.
Is your first pet? Which one?
Dog. I have adopted stray dogs when I was very small. In my lower primary school itself, I started adopting dogs.
Mm-hmm.
So eventually, I love all the animals. Of that, I love dogs the most. And of all the dogs, I love stray dogs. Even now, I have four.
Mm.
Three are kids and one is their mother. Yeah. All stray dogs.
So you have good hair. So do you have any expensive hairdo?
No, I don't. I believe that mostly it is your genetic makeup. Yeah, you have inherited it. That is what makes your hair like this. You have to thank your mother and father for whatever you have. So I believe that is it. And I use a lot of oil. From being from Kerala, I have to use oil.
We use
a lot of oil on our hair.
Eat oil, you keep oil, everything is like
coconut
oil.
Coconut oil on the hair is a must for us.
Okay. Most expensive thing you bought but regretted?
I bought a new car. I cannot name the company. It won't be nice. But then after buying it, I thought I shouldn't have bought it.
Oh. Can we know how much expensive is that?
That is too much anger. Sorry about that. But then eventually, the thing is that I was, the car wasn't that expensive. Okay, the car was expensive, of course, but then...
But why did you get regretted about it?
But then the maintenance of that car was going over my head. So I thought I shouldn't have bought it.
Okay, most expensive thing you have received? Something like gift. You can call it gift.
I would say more than being expensive, there are touchy gifts your fans give you all the time. So, I cannot name one, but every time when you receive something of that sort, I feel really, really happy. Okay, if somebody starts calling you their own brother or their own, they make you a part of their family, it's a major thing, which something like you feel like you have achieved something to reach there.
Mm-hmm.
So, that is very expensive than the monetary, what do you say, the price tag attached with the gift.
Most expensive gift you have gave to somebody?
No, I wouldn't say it's expensive. That is a life experience for me. So there was a time in Malayalam industry when I had a satellite value, in Malayalam industry. So eventually a group of friends were trying to make a movie with me as the lead, but then that time I was not a star or I had any value of that, and that project got delayed because I was not having any value. But then when I got the value, I called them and I asked them I will do the movie. The movie was not good. I wouldn't say that it was a great movie. It was not a great movie. But then I lost my satellite value with that. After doing the movie, my mistakes are only my mistakes. I'm not blaming anyone. But I felt that I should do that for them, because they planned that movie on me when I was nobody. So that proved to be very expensive in my career.
You look like fitness freak, so I want to ask you a few diet related questions.
Yep.
What is the diet, your like best diet you ever had?
No, I've been maintaining the diet for almost when I was doing my degree itself, I started dieting. So I make it a point that I don't skip my diet whenever possible. So it's been years I've been following it. So
what do you eat for lunch, breakfast, and
so the thing is that after your breakfast, the lunch and the dinner, that principle have to go. So for me, it's about having food in every 2 to 2.5 hours whenever possible. When you're traveling, sometimes it's not possible, but otherwise every 2 to 2.5 hours you need to keep
don't
eating.
Don't we put on weight?
No, that is when you reduce. That is the wrong notion which people have. But you have to, it is like your digestive enzymes are produced and you are giving something for the digestive enzymes to digest. When you're eating a big amount of food, the quantity is more, your digestive enzymes are not, the quantity of the enzymes are not that much that the food can be digested. You understand what I'm saying? So eventually what happens is undigested food or undigested energy are deposited as fat. So it is best to have a food in a small interval and not a lot, maybe 30, 35, 40% of your appetite. Stop it, then have it after some time. and eventually finish it off at 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock. That's it. So that is the way I feel you should eat.
Mm.
But again, it depends from person to person. But that is what I follow. Whatever I'm saying is what I follow and whatever I think.
Yeah.
Okay.
We can see your results, so that's why I'm asking you this question. Yeah. So there are so many boys who are trying to build muscles that you have. So one tip for them. I'll show you this. What do you call?
But it's visor, but then it is a full sleeve. I cannot show. But
yeah,
nothing.
That, yeah.
But then the tip is that making is very easy. Making is very easy for boys and girls. It's different. For boys, you have to be very careful because your musculature will be formed, and on top of that, you will have a layer of fat. Your muscles won't be seen. So you have to be very, very strict on your diet. Only then the musculature will be seen. Making is easy. You have to put on 300%, 400%, 500% of effort to maintain it. You make the musculature, for example, you show it in a movie or a photo shoot or a video shoot or something of that sort, and in 15 days you have a layer of fat on your abdomen itself. Okay, your packs will be concealed. So I'm not an advocate of that. I believe even if it is a minimal fitness, maintain it, right? Not that you make it and then you leave it and after some time you make it. No, I don't support that. I despise that kind of thing. For me, it's like whatever you have, maintain it. The diet is 80%. Okay. So whatever you have, if you control your food, you can control your musculature very easily.
Yeah. Yes. And I'll ask you a few questions.
Yeah.
Telugu film industry, do you watch any film?
We watch all the movies. Yeah. It comes. I mean, come
okay,
on.
Okay. Now
all
I can ask
come.
You.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who is your Tollywood favorite star?
No, I have to say my friend's name. I mean, he's my friend also.
Who's that?
Akhil is a friend
Akhil
of mine.
Akhil?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
He's a close friend of mine.
Oh, okay.
Then,
how long your friends?
5, 6, 7 years. 6, 7 years. So 2014, 6 years. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you both cricket friends?
Yeah, yeah. We started as cricket friends then, oh. Yeah.
I thought, I got it, yeah. So
then Venkatesh sir, then I have Tarun, and then Ashwin Babu, Vishwa.
These all are cricket players, right?
Yeah, yeah. Whom I meet, Sandeep Kishan.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. I have friends over here, yes.
Yeah. So one thing you most admire in Venkatesh Garu?
Oh,
he's like very energetic, right?
He is every day before we reach the gym, he will reach the gym. He'll do the workout and then he controls his food and then he is so damn down to earth. That is what I like about, even if it is the smallest guys in the room also, you will go to him and treat him as a friend or give him respect. That kind of, you know, you, in spite of being a superstar, if you treat somebody like that, you have to admire that person, right? You have to grab whatever good qualities are there in that person. You have to imbibe that. So I feel Venkatesh sir is, I have huge respect for him.
Okay, one thing about Akhil.
Akhil is a true friend. Whenever you need, he's there. He's a true friend, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you receive any help from him?
No, it's
because
not
you said if I needed, he'll
no,
be there.
No, it's not about being help. If you're one phone call away, okay, you need to ask him something. If he's not picking up, he will call back.
Oh.
That kind of thing, yeah.
Wow, superb. So finally, so Rajiv, what you wanted to say your audience about Shakilan movie?
Shakilan movie is a realistic take on Shakila, in fact. 70% at least has happened in her life. So she, in spite of being a star, she had gone through a lot of hardships and people have treated her really badly. So do watch the movie, understand what has gone through in her life. It is more of a realistic take on that life. So do watch it. You may like it, you may not like it, but you would love to watch it.
Wow. Thank you so much and wish you very good luck.
Thank you. Thank you. So sweet of you. Thank you.